Hey everybody, my name is Ferocus, and welcome to Until Dawn. Now we're gonna start a new. Wait 1 second. Alright, subtitles on. Let's start a new story. I've played this once before, and I won't spoil how it ended the first time. This is kind of like, similar to Heavy Rain, how it has multiple endings, and it kind of plays similar. Alright, starting a new story, yeah. It's overwrite. Butterfly effect. A tiny butterfly flapping its wings today may lead to a devastating hurricane tomorrow. The smallest decision can dramatically change the future. Your actions will shape how the story unfolds. Your story is one of many possibilities. Choose your actions carefully. Okay.
Hannah.
Hey, Hannah.
Hey, did you see that? Dad said it'd just be us this weekend. Josh.
Okay. What do we have here? Hannah, you look so damn hot in that shirt, but I bet you're even hotter out of it. Come to the guest room at 2 a.m., Mike.
Oh my God. What did our naive sister get herself into now? Ugh. Intervention time.
Alright, how do I get up there? I don't exactly remember how this. Every detail of this starts off. That's what we got here. That's just a note again. Never mind. Anything? Oh. Jeremiah Craig. I can't even read what that says. It's obviously some kind of alcohol. That's the best I can figure out. This whole prank that they're pulling is just all kinds of mean.
Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out. Hannah.
I'm sorry, Hannah. Hey. It's all
got
out of hand.
Just a stupid prank.
Hey,
you guys.
Oh God, he has a selfie stick. Let's be safe. Alright, now there's collectibles you can find, totems that lie around. I know there's one nearby somewhere here. Oh, I think I see it.
Hello?
Yeah, that's gotta be it right there. Yeah. Not only do these give you, like, a little glimpse at something that may or may not happen, helps unlock bonus shit. So, this is a death totem, so this is showing that someone's gonna die. Or could die.
Hannah!
No, I didn't want to bring that up. Okay, what the fuck is that?
Hannah! Hannah!
Hello?
Hannah! Oh my God, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat. I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb. Hannah?
Jesus Christ.
You may think I just fucked up, but you can't avoid that. Oh, this fucker. It's creepy.
Before we begin, there are a few things I need to make sure you understand. You see, no one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward. But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything you do, every decision you make, now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you. So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant. And I want to help you see it through. Sometimes these things can be a little scary, even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, you will always find a way to work through. All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up a card? And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it. It is essential that you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience.
Okay.
So, how did that picture make you feel? Remember, be honest.
Uneasy.
It's good. What do you think it is that makes you feel uneasy?
The scarecrow.
Oh, I see. Let's see. The scarecrow were not there. Would you feel comfortable staying there on your own for a period of time? Say a week, for example.
Sure, I guess.
Huh. And what if I told you that this cottage was haunted?
Meh, wouldn't care.
So, the scarecrow frightens you, and yet you don't appear to be bothered by the possibility of the supernatural. I suspect that someone is not being entirely honest with me. Our time's up. Let's investigate that in our next session, shall we?
You can call me a liar if you want, but you're forgetting one very important thing. I don't care.
Yeah. one-year anniversary of the dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Annie Klein is in charge of the investigation.
Thanks for having me, Marty.
This is an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play.
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Thank you for joining us, Annie. With all the Washingtons tonight, their son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again. All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I'm super excited to welcome all my pals back the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. So, let me just let you know, let's take a moment to address the elephant in the room for a second. I know you're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and that I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, and I'm thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters, and, you know. Okay, so let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right? Yes!
So there we go, Sam. My favorite character in the game.
Hello? Is someone there?
Alright, we have to get to the cable car. Gates busted. Climb over, Chris. I want to take 1 second. Settings. Are you serious? I can't disable the... I want to disable the tutorial tips. Alright. Let's get up there quick. Not like anything bad could happen, right? See? Easy peasy. Even when it's a squirrel, those stupid, don't move segments always get me, on edge. Indigenous people and butterfly prophecies. Tribes who once lived in these mountains believed that butterflies carried dreams and prophecies of possible futures. The color of the butterfly indicated the nature of the prophecy. Death. Black butterflies prophesied the dreamer's death. Red butterflies warned of dangerous events. Brown butterflies foretold of tragedy affecting friends. Yellow butterflies offered visions to help and guide. White butterflies brought dreams of luck and good fortune. So, pretty much the same thing as the totems. Come on. Pick up the fucking thing. Thank you. Okay.
Chris, you here? Max here, where are you? You're not in the bag, are you?
I should close the bag. I'll be nice.
Chris?
Sam, hey, you made it.
Chris has a crush on Ashley.
Oh, so I found something kind of amazing.
What?
I'm not going to tell you. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, it's this way.
Where?
Right around here. Blow your mind.
The hell's this? Wanted Victor Milgram. That must be the guy with the machete and flamethrower that keeps walking around. Okay.
Wow, nice shooting.
Okay, that's practically a Fortnite dance, so.
I don't think so, girl.
Well, anybody and their brother can shoot a bottle that big, that close.
Gonna leave a loaded gun there. Yeah, that's a great idea. Alright, that's where we're gonna end this episode. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.